Hello, and thank you for joining us for this presentation of MicroStrategy's Office Integration into Alfresco. Now, in front of you, you see Microsoft Word 2007. This integration works with 2007, 2010, as well as XP, and of course, Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. For this demonstration, I put together a quick paragraph just to help us along. Once I've got my document in front of me, I go to the menu, and I click Save to Alfresco. When I do, it'll pull up the screen that'll allow me to select the appropriate folder and assign the appropriate properties. Now, in this section right here, you'll notice where it says Client ID and Matter ID. Depending on the implementation would depend on what you see here. This integration was done for a law firm, so they use Client ID and Matter ID. For other installations we've done, it's been vendor name or vendor number, sometimes project name, project number, customer name, customer number. So it really depends on the client's needs as to what we're using right here, what those identifiers are. Okay, so I'm going to enter a matter number. Now, when I'm doing this lookup, this is validating against an external system. In this case, a matter management system. For the client we did with the vendor work, that was validated against Oracle Financials. So again, depending on what we're doing from validation would depend on what we're talking to in terms of that external system. Now, it pulled up the appropriate folder, 11285. I select that folder, and all of a sudden on the right, the property information is ready for me to enter. Now, again, this is matter information, okay, because as I said earlier, this is a legal implementation, and again, it could be vendor or project or what have you. Up top here, where you see classifications, the idea here is akin to aspects is classifications. In other words, by virtue of selecting these, it'll control what properties are available for me to enter. So if I select invoice right here, notice what happens down at the property piece. Now I'm presented with all these additional properties. So depending on the classifications you choose will depend on the properties available to you for saving this document, of course, searching later. So I'll choose my doc type and my document subtype. And of course, this parent-child relationship between type and subtype is managed by the users. And I'll choose a status. And I'll enter my title, an optional field. If I want, I can also enter comments on this particular document to be stored with this document. And that's it. And from here, I can just click Save, and it would save the document. Want to show you a couple other things really quick. One, your name over here. We can enter a document name, as you'd expect when you're saving. Control that name. As well as keep lock. Now, the idea behind keep lock is when you're working on a document, you may want to get it up to the repository so other people can look at it. Okay? The idea, if I say keep lock and save, it will take this current version of the document, put it into the repository so other users can search and review it while you continue to work on it here on your desktop. The other piece I want to show you is notice where I have matter document right here, checked. What could also happen is instead of searching straight to a folder, say in this case a matter folder or a vendor folder, I might want to navigate through the folders, okay, through a tree, if you will. If I uncheck this, it will allow me to navigate through that tree. So again, I've selected my classifications, entered my properties, and I just hit save, and the document's now saved in Alfresco. Save was successful, and I click OK, and we're all set. Opening a document from Alfresco is just as simple. I go to my menu, I click Open from Alfresco, and up pops a screen that allowed me to get to my particular file. Now, there's a couple of different ways to get to the file. You can do what we talked about earlier, whereas I enter identifiers here to get to a particular folder, or I could just click Recent Documents, and what will pop up is the last 30 documents that I've worked with. And you'll see the Albany contract was the last one I did. The other option you have is you can do a document search. So right from within here, you could do a simple search, which is really, in this case, the matter ID, but again, depending on your implementation, could be vendor or could be project ID, what have you. You could do searching inside the text of the document to be able to find it. You could do a more advanced search. So in other words, enter more criteria to be able to find that document. Created, created date, created by, modified by. Remember, the objective here is if you don't know where the document is that you want to open from within side Office, you can use his advanced search to go off and find it. Now, we'll go to recent documents. Like I said, I'll select my document and I'll click open. Up pops my new document, and from here I can make any changes. When I'm done making these changes, I go to the menu, I click save. So I'm saving to Alfresco, and when I pop up this screen, it'll automatically have the existing properties filled out. So here's my Albany document. It knows what document I checked out. The properties are already assigned. If I want, I can enter more comments. And then I'd click save. Now, when I click save, it will ask me, is this going to be a minor version change, a major, or to replace the existing one? And I can enter any comments on the version. And when I click OK, the newest version of my document is now saved in the repository, and we're good to go.